Okay, we're back outside the ice cap zone there. Oh, no, don't fall in the water, Sonic. It makes you go slower. And now we have to go out this way. I don't think this door is open yet. No, wait, I have to go back to Station Square. I just remembered that. I'm going over to a carnival-like area next, if I'm not mistaken. So, let's just do it, and fall down this hole and go back to Station Square. You remember where the train station is? Okay, I was evidently pretty wrong about that, so let's go back to the Mystic Ruins here, and I believe maybe it's the Knuckles event that's coming up. Yeah, it's Knuckles event. Pardon me! How's it going?
What's up, Knuckles?
Hey, I said pardon me, not what's up. Whoa! What the heck was that?
Something bugging you?
Obviously.
No time for games, Sonic. Give me the emeralds you have, right now.
What the? How do you know I have emeralds?
What? Let's just see you take them, huh?
And why do you want my emeralds? We're trying to keep them from away from Eggman. Alright, bring it on, Knuckles. All you have to do is, just don't jump and dash at him in midair. That is pretty much it, yeah. He can also block your jump dashes. It's nothing really that special. Yeah, it's already over. It's like one of the easiest boss fights ever. Oh no, my emeralds!
The Chaos Emeralds!
He's back! He was waiting for us! Ah, you sneaky, sneaky snake! What? Why are you surprised? Were you tricked, Knuckles? That's what it's sounding like. I'm afraid so. Sonic wasn't tricked. You started attacking Sonic. Oh no, he's got 4 out of 7! He's in the lead! Oh no, he's gotten even bigger and more vicious. His arm looks more like mechanical or bony. I don't know what to call it, but they're more claw-like. Oh no, what's going on? Well, that's not good. That's never good. Obviously not. We gotta make our own slack. We gotta cut that rubber band. Ah, loading screen. It was getting all exciting, then the loading screen breaks up the action. And here we go! This is Chaos 4. To hit him, all you have to do is just jump dash at him, or should say homing attack at him, when he pops his head out of the water. And he also knocks out the lily pads that you stand on. If you ever fall into the water and stay in there for too long, you'll take a hit. So don't stay in the water for too long. You've got to, like, really sink down into the water to take a hit. So don't really worry about it. The water may as well just be, like, another platform. It's that harmless to you if you keep yourself jumping. And there's hit number 2. If I'm not mistaken, he takes 5 hits, which is the most of any Chaos form, if I'm not mistaken. No, wait, there's one more. Never mind. I'm thinking of something else. Anyway, in this little attack here, he turns into water bubbles, large water bubbles, like gooiness, and he then reforms wherever those lights are. Ah! Don't do that, you dang water lily pad controls. And whenever he pops out of the water again, just hit him, homing attack. Not much to say whatsoever. All these attacks are easily dodgeable. Though he tries to sink these lily pads, eventually with like little bursts of water such as that, to make it harder for you to stay on solid ground, but it's still just as easy because the water blasts don't hurt you whatsoever. And man, how the heck did I miss him there? I have no idea. Since pretty much everything is a safe spot, and he barely even has any attacks that goes after you, except for that wave attack that, not that one, the energy blast attack, I should say, that skims across the water. He's pretty much one of the most harmless bosses ever. And now he just did two little waves there of energy, but that was still pretty weak. And that's all there is to this boss fight, seriously. It's just chaos as a fish. And we all know that fish are typically a pretty harmless creature, which I just proved right there by whooping him. Yeah. That's all I have to say about that boss. Because that's over. It was easy. Way too easy. It was kind of sad. Ooh. Uh-oh. I'm not liking the looks of this. Oh my god, it's Eggman ship! Look at the symbol! Ah, loading screen! Why do you betray me? Ah, poopers, not the egg carrier. Adieu. By the way, I love Eggman's voice actor in this game. I love it. I believe that the guy who played Eggman's voice actor in this game actually died, so that's kind of sad. So rest in peace, guy. I used to know his name. I don't remember his name. I'm sorry, Sonic fans, for forgetting his name. But yeah, it's very depressing in a way. Well, actually, it is very depressing, because he was a great Eggman actor. Anyway, now I can play with Knuckles, and now I go to the station square, if I'm not mistaken. I don't want to mess this up again by going the wrong way. Dang it, camera. Do not fail. Ugh, camera. Work with me here. I'm looking for a little light bubble somewhere around here. Well, I might as well go to station square anyway, because I know there's one there. We have arrived! And now we're gonna go to that carnival area, if I'm not mistaken. I'm gonna touch the bubble just to make sure. I better be right this time. The Mystic Ruins- Oh, what the heck? Okay, now you'll see Knuckles over here. Now I know I'm going the right way. You can talk to him right here.
What are you waiting for?
Yeah, he's basically saying, what are you waiting for? Go this way, for the love of God. Because you keep forgetting where to go because you're in Sonic Adventure Noob. Anyway, now you can go into Tails' world. Well, not you don't go into it. Tails will go into
it.
Wait
here for a second.
And he'll configure something inside, and you wait around. Things just happen. You get bored, and, yeah. Casually walk over there. It doesn't seem, like, very characteristic of Sonic. You rarely see him walk. What the heck? Something exploded. Oh my goodness! It wasn't an explosion. Something was opening up! A runway is coming out of this long stretch of land hanging over the cliff, and the palm trees are evidently mechanical! It's amazing! How do they stay alive? Maybe they're in giant vases or something. I don't know. Alright! By the way, Sonic is not buckled in whatsoever. He's just standing on the back of the aircraft. How does he stand on the aircraft? What does he have, like magnetic boots or something? Anyway, this is Sky Chase Act 1, a sub-game. You can shoot by pressing the A button. You can lock on the stuff by holding the A button and then shooting. It'll shoot like little homing bullets or something like that. That's a great way to get a lot of points at one time. The more stuff you lock onto, the more points you get. Anyway, as you see, we're catching up to the egg carrier. And lock onto as much stuff as you possibly can and shoot them down.
Woo!
Yeah, you'll never miss if you lock onto them. So just make sure that you just hold the lock on button the whole time. And I gotta say, the way you can control this plane is quite pretty dang erratic. I mean, seriously, look how much control you have over this thing. It's so very touchy. And I gotta say, it makes dodging things pretty dang easy as well. So I guess it's not much of a problem. But it doesn't make much sense from an aircraft sort of perspective. And we're gonna go right below, right behind Eggman's thrusters there. Surprisingly, we don't get blown away or burnt to a crisp. Try and shoot down those little cannon shooters off in the background there, because those will keep shooting at you until you blow them up. And as I said, keep locking onto as many things as you possibly can. I took a hit there, that's okay. Those shooters, those cannons off to the side, they're pretty good shots and they shoot pretty fast bullets, so you don't want to leave them around for too long, especially when they can keep shooting at you. And so yeah, this is all pretty much an auto-scroll area, as much as you can make an auto-scroll area in a 3D game, so to speak. And the camera will flip around, we'll go to the other side, we'll try to blow up the other side of this ship, and that's looking pretty good there. Look at how many things I can lock onto. Holy poopers! There's so many things that she'll shoot at you, and I'm getting shot at, and I just took a hit. Ow! I kind of hurt a little bit, but it's okay, the tornado will hold through. And we're coming near the end of this little sequence. We're eventually going to get shot out of the sky. I'm just a little spoilers for you there. So don't get your hopes up that we're actually going to make it on top of the egg carrier this time. We don't have the amount of power that we need to. And here's the end of the sequence. I got 6,465 points. That was kind of a weak score. I'm sure you could beat it. If you can, post a video response. I'd like to see it. And uh-oh. Holy Pooper is firing his laser! No, my wing! We're out of control! Anyway, yeah, that's the end of Sky Chase there. It's just like a little side minigame. It's actually pretty hard to lose on it if you're paying it, unless you're not paying attention, I should say. Well, anyway, that about does it for this part. There's gonna be a little cutscene, and that's it. Oh no, Sonic! He's falling through the air, he's gonna land in the sand! Wow, that was a high-pitched noise. Ow!
Tails?
I guess this part isn't over quite yet. So I guess you gotta end this cutscene, and then I'll be able to end this part. And yeah, Sonic is head first in the sand, even though he looked like he was falling butt first. And where'd Tails go? I must find Tails.
Oh, I wonder if he's okay.
I gotta go find Tails, which I will do in the next part. So I hope you guys enjoyed this part, and I will see you later. Toodaloo.